Which 3D shape has no faces, no edges, and no vertices?
Welcome back. In our last math quest, we worked with polygons. All polygons are flat 2D shapes. In order to solve our quest today, we must now look at solid 3D shapes and the features they're made of: faces, edges, and vertices. Unlike flat 2D shapes, 3D shapes pop out and take up space. Look around and you'll find so many examples of these 3D shapes because we live in a 3D world. To answer today's math quest, we'll have to investigate some 3D shapes to figure out how many faces, edges, and vertices they have. Follow along with me in your guided notes. Let's start with a cube. Can you think of any real-world objects shaped like cubes? When I think of cubes, I think of the dice we use to play games. Each side of a cube is a 2D square. When 2D surfaces are on a 3D shape, they're called faces. How many faces are on this cube? If we compare the cube to dice, we can see that cubes have 6 faces, just like how you can roll a 1 through 6 when rolling dice. The next part of the cube we're going to look at is its edges. Remember, edges are the places where two surfaces of a solid shape meet. How many edges does this cube have? Let's count them together. There are 4 edges around the top of the cube and 4 edges around the bottom of the cube, plus there are 4 more edges around the cube, making a total of 12 edges. Okay. We've looked at the faces and edges, but what about these vertices? Which part of the cube do you think could be the vertices? Since we've already figured out the faces and edges, the only part of the cube left is these corners. On 3D shapes, a corner is called a vertex. When we have lots of corners, we call them vertices. So, how many vertices are there on the cube? Count with me. There are 4 vertices around the top of the shape and 4 more vertices around the bottom of the shape. That gives us a total of 8 vertices. Great work! Our math quest wants us to find a shape with no faces, edges, or vertices. We figured out faces on a 3D shape are made of 2D shapes we already know. Since the cube has faces made of squares, it can't be the answer to our math quest. What about shapes that have 2D sides that are round like a circle? Cylinders have circles as a part of the shape, but do they have any faces, edges, or vertices? Follow along with me in your guided notes. Are there any faces on this cylinder? There are 2. Circles are flat 2D shapes, just like the squares on a cube, which makes them faces. Does the cylinder have edges? Yes. These 2 curved edges connect to the curved surface of the cylinder. Are there any vertices? No, there aren't any vertices on this shape. The cylinder has 2 faces, 2 edges, and 0 vertices. Can it be the answer to our math quest? No, it's not the answer to our math quest because it has faces and edges. So far, we know the answer to our math quest cannot be a cube or a cylinder because they both have at least 1 of the features we're looking at today. Is it even possible for a shape to have no faces, no edges, and no vertices? Oh, look, a hint with questions to help us narrow down our choices. Ooh, here are 4 different shapes that could be the answer and some questions to help us. Which one of these figures has 6 faces? Which one of the remaining shapes is made of polygons? Which of these shapes has 1 vertex? These will definitely help us narrow down which shape we're looking for. Follow along with me in your guided notes as we work through each of these questions. Let's look at the first one. Which one of these figures has six faces? Yes, the rectangular prism has six faces, just like the cube we looked at. The solution cannot be the rectangular prism because we need a shape with no faces. Next question. Which of the remaining shapes is made of polygons? Which shape could it be? What about this shape? It has triangles all around it with a square on the bottom. Do you know what it is? This shape is called a pyramid. We figured out that any 3D shape made out of polygons would have faces, edges, and vertices. That means the pyramid couldn't be the answer to the math quest, since it is made of triangles and a square. Only two shapes left. Let's check the last question. Which of these shapes has one vertex? Remember, a vertex is like a corner on the shape. Do you see a shape here that only has one? Exactly. The cone only has one vertex at the top of the shape. The cone cannot be the answer because we need a shape with no vertices. After narrowing the choices down, we're left with the sphere. Let's take a closer look at the sphere to make sure it's the answer we're looking for. Do you see any faces on the sphere? That's right. There aren't any flat surfaces on the sphere. It's round. So there are no faces. What about edges? No edges either. There would have had to be at least two separate surfaces of the shape meeting to create an edge. Ooh, we're so close. Let's check for the last feature. Are there any vertices? You're right. There are no vertices or corners on the sphere. This is definitely the shape we're looking for. Write our final answer on your math quest while I input our answer. We figured out the math quest. Nice work today. Remember, every problem has a solution, and we've got the skills to solve it. See you next time. Hey.